The government's efforts to balance the fiscal in the midst of high financing needs are considered a fundamental mistake in the state budget posture. Economists say that the overly optimistic state budget posture will only lead to a wider deficit.
Problems in state budget management are allegedly disrupting the continuity of state budget in carrying out government programs. In-depth economist Abra Talatov explained that so far, the Ministry of Finance has always set tax targets that are too high to illustrate the government's optimism. But in fact, over the last few years, tax revenue is still far from the target. Abra assessed that even before the pandemic, the government was difficult to push taxes, which on average only grew by 2.9%. This means that the tax growth target of 7 to 8% is something that is forced.
Kita juga harus bisa mengukur, jangan sampai target yang terlalu overestimasi tadi, overestimate itu akan berimplikasi terhadap belanja yang juga tinggi, ya. Kemudian defisitnya juga nanti akan akan melebar lagi kalau penerimaan pajaknya tidak mencapai target. Nah, kemudian juga indikator lain yang menunjukkan kinerja pajak kita sudah lolos sebelum pandemi adalah rasio perpajakannya, tax ratio dan juga tax buoyancy. Jadi hubungan antara pertumbuhan ekonomi dengan pertumbuhan penerimaan perpajakan kita yang relatif rendah sebelum pandemi.
The Ministry of Finance noted that until July 2021, the realization of tax revenues reached 647.7 trillion rupiah from the 2021 target of 1,229.6 trillion. With state revenue still low, the state budget deficit was recorded at 336.9 trillion rupiah. From Jakarta, Raharjo Patmo for IEX Channel.